Cities around the world face challenges such as segregation and inequality. But what if there was a tool that could help us to make fact-based decisions for a sustainable future? My name is Marcel Moritz, and I'm going to show you how we can build more sustainable cities using facts and visualizations.
Data from all countries. I'm going to show you the world in a new way. I'm going to tell you how
Gapminder have helped us to understand global development. Now we use the same tool open for everyone online to visualize and understand data, but at a local level. We will start by looking at Stockholm region in Sweden with its 2.3 million inhabitants. For decades, there have been lots of projects aiming to close the gap between the rich and poor neighborhoods. What has been the result? In the tool, you can now see the Stockholm region broken down into around 1,300 different neighborhoods, each one represented by a bubble. On the vertical axis, you see the proportion of higher education, and on the horizontal axis, you see the average income. In other words, neighborhoods in the top right are rich and educated, and the bottom left have lower education and income. Has Stockholm got less segregated? Have the differences become smaller? Let us see what has happened since year 2000. We see that the whole region has had a positive development towards more knowledge and higher incomes, but if you look closely, you can see that some neighborhoods are left behind. They aren't progressing at the same rate. And those are the neighborhoods that already had lower levels of income and education at the start. Despite of all our efforts, we are seeing growing differences between neighborhoods. There are, of course, many reasons for this. But one thing we have learned in the work against segregation is that there is something we can call workdrain, or Lyckoparadoxen in Swedish. Right now, we are at Tensta Träff, a meeting place in Järvafältet. We will look specifically at Järvafältet and add a whole new parameter: people who are employed and move in the region. Bubbles moving down in the graph are losing employed inhabitants, and those moving up are gaining employed inhabitants. What has happened? We can see that these neighborhoods are losing working people every year. People settle here, but once they have a job, they move. Since 2000, over 10,000 people with jobs have moved away from Järvafältet, and this is a huge number when it's around 50,000 people living here. With that in mind, it's not so strange that the average income is not raised when every year this area is being drained of people who work. Work drain. But what is it that makes people move away from these areas? Of course, there are, again, many reasons. But research suggests that neighborhoods' socioeconomic status depends on the housing mix. Can this be connected to work drain? Let's look at one variable for housing mix: the share of rental apartments. Where red means that there are many rental apartments in the area, and blue means that there are few rental apartments. The connection seems to be clear. It is a correlation between the poor areas with work drain and a high degree of rental houses. Which means that people who get a new job and more money and wants to get a house or a larger apartment has problems to stay in the neighborhood. So maybe a better housing mix in these areas and as well in the whole region could be one way to try to close the gap between the rich and poor neighborhoods. This quick look at neighborhoods, work drain, and housing mix are just some examples on how to use this tool for analyzing facts. At this time, the tool is available for the Stockholm region, but it can be used everywhere. We know that there are similar challenges in other cities, both in Sweden and across the globe. And if we are going to build sustainable cities, the decisions we make must be based on facts.